In his career, by the man to my left, a man who enjoyed a stellar career in the NHL of 27 seasons, Chris Chelios. And I guess first question is it weird not preparing for an NHL season for the first time in about three decades?
I don't know so much if it's weird, but I sure didn't train as hard as I have in the past. But I was prepared. I mean, I knew last year that was going to be the last year. And like we talked about earlier, I played long enough where I hope I won't miss it. But there's nothing like playing. I'm not going to try and kid myself, but it's going to be an easy adjustment knowing all the guys in the Red Wings organization, working with Jim Nill and Kenny and Kirk Frazier and Jim Peck. So hopefully it'll make the transition that much easier and I won't miss it as much playing.
Tell me what you're hoping to learn throughout this whole process of now stepping into the executive end of the sport.
Well, I guess the first thing is finding out what I really want to do, whether it's coaching or management in some capacity. I know I don't want to travel because I've been doing that 27 years, but I've got kids of my own that I'm looking forward to seeing them participate in their stuff for at least a year. But right now, it looks like the most I'll be doing is working with a young defenseman in a player development role where I'm going to go to Grand Rapids a couple times a month, work with their young defenseman, then travel a little bit to Boston and maybe Quebec to watch two other young kids.
You got a buddy running a team now, Steve Yzerman. Have you spoken to him at all about his experiences so far?
Yeah, I thought the fact that he studied under the best people here under management with Kenny and Jim, that he felt he was ready, and then he did the Team Canada. He spent a year with Team Canada, the Olympics, and gave him some more experience as a general manager. So I think for Steve, he got a Harvard degree here with Detroit and moved on to Tampa, and I wish him nothing but the best. And he's probably a little nervous leaving the same organizations he's been with for so long, but I think he's going to do a great job for that team.
Everybody talks about how unbelievably tough it is to get to the NHL and then to stay there. How in the heck did you do that for 27 years?
Like I said, I was in the right place at the right time. Kind of a freak story how I did finally get my opportunity. And then, like you said, establishing yourself and staying there. After my first 13 games in Montreal, I was ready to go to Sherbrooke and then probably be done and working in a restaurant. But like you said, 28 years later, I was fortunate enough I didn't have to uproot my family the last 10, which is one of the big decisions players have to make at the end of their career. But right place at the right time, great teams in all three teams I played for, and that really kept me around the longest.
Thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you.
Chris Chelios starting the next phase of his hockey life, and no doubt 5 years from now you'll see a plaque with his face on it in Toronto at the Hall of Fame. Three Stanley Cups.